Hello and welcome to the next part of Roland Dielen's Voss and Sky. We're diving into that fantastic E major section in the middle. We're checking out all the fingers, chords and hacks that you need. I have changed the score. I'm sorry, Dielen's. I had to. It just made it slightly easier. So we will check out Dielen's fingering and my own. Let's dive straight into Roland Dielen's Voss and Sky E major section. Alrighty. Micro study number one. New key. Feeling. We are literally E major. I'm using fingers 2 and 3, even though Dielen's has suggested 1 and 2 for one very simple reason. The next bar we have an E sharp. So this is nothing. Waltz right there, E sharp. Leaving my second finger down. Now, in the score, Dielen's is actually after this effect. Hammer on that first C sharp in the next bar, 98, but I play it purely because you can't hear it and it's gone by that point, but that is the effect that Dielen's wants. It's also double P and dolcissimo, so as sweet as possible. First finger E sharp, fourth finger C sharp, second finger stays down, third finger off. 98. Next bar, first finger slides up to bar 2. 4 is hammering and going on to string 2. 2 and 3. 2 and 3 in the middle. Second finger up. First finger on D sharp. Okay, nice and slowly, here we go. That is your first microstudy. There is a lot there. Your fourth finger is doing a lot, so you're gonna have to really work on those slurs, but it's not impossible. Main thing though is right hand fine control. I should not be hearing this. No. Subtlety. It's Dielen's. Welcome to the next micro study. Bar 101, we're picking it up again. We're here back at E. Fourth finger on an F sharp, first finger on a G sharp. Double octave E to finish. And again, staccato. Now, I would probably suggest that Dielen's wanted a rest stroke on that E to really make it zing out across the bar. But that is your choice. I'm using the backside of my nail to achieve my A finger melody note, so it's quite loud anyway. And if I do a rest stroke on that, it's even louder. So that is your choice. Right, here we go. Lovely. Chord here. G sharp, B sharp, D sharp, G sharp. Slides down. So third, second, half bar at 1, 1, 1, hammer on. And Dielen's has said suavissimo, so make it sexy. We're then into bar 103. And second finger on a C sharp, fourth finger on an F sharp, first finger on a G sharp, so 1 and 4. Everything stops. Next bar, 104. I'm using Dielen's fingering here. It's all in 4th fret. 2, 3, 4. Second finger goes down from the G. Staccato, staccato, back down. And then we're into bar 105, the next microstudy in essence. So all together from bar 101, it sounds like this. Five, things are starting to get interesting. We're now in the key of F sharp minor, kind of. So bars cross second fret for pretty much everything here. All the other fingers are going to be nice and loose and relaxed. Here we go. third finger on an F sharp, first finger doing duty on the A, and then we get this, where your third finger is going to jump from here to here. And your second finger is going to go down on the F natural. Then you're going to hammer on fourth finger. Notice how everything stays, and I've got a slight angle on my first finger. And then your fourth finger is going to move up, so we've gone from fourth fret to fifth fret. Third finger off by this point. From bar 109, it's going to be I am, thumb, thumb. To get those notes nice and clear, but Deans has already put that in the score. I'm going to step through that again. Welcome to bar 110. Now, things get really fantastic here. A lot of right hand fine control. We have a bar across the second fret, third finger on a G sharp. Can you hear my bass is staying on, but the notes are not? So we have almost a trumpet sound here. Ba, ba. Second finger down on D natural or C double sharp in the score. Everything's going to come off at this point. So first finger, third finger back on a D sharp, and then it is open B. First finger stays down now on fourth fret. Third fret. So we have this wonderful back into the main melody section at 113, but on top of that we have open B and high B, but that is staccato. Deans has put above here humoristico, so humorous. It's again this famous Deans humor that he loves putting in all of his pieces. It's part of his language, so you've got to play with it and have fun with it. All right, I am leaving my first finger down and just all of that staccato work has been done with my left hand fourth finger. It might take a little bit to get practicing, but I suggest you just do. Notice how I'm stretching, because if I don't stretch, the note sounds pans. It's just that simple, so you've got to make sure that you're on the edge of the fret. Back in. Right, let's take a look at this in slow motion. To the next micro study. We're at 113. In essence, we're back to the opening idea and material from 97, but with a reharmonization. So we have a 4-3, which is what I suggest here. Then your second finger is going to go up onto the C sharp. First finger on a D sharp, third finger on an A to get this chord. Now, the next one is quite a quick change. Your third finger is going to flip out quickly onto G natural or F double sharp. Second finger is going to start doing the hammer-ons, and first finger goes down onto an E. Fourth finger comes out in this position. Fourth fret, G sharp. And then we move into a more comfortable position at 117. First finger on a G sharp, open B. B sharp again, and into the next microstudy. So it's just Dean's reharmonizing this in the beginning to this. Composer does. Right, let's check out the next microstudy. Hi, hope you're enjoying this. If you are, consider hitting the like button and maybe subscribing to the channel. There is going to be a ton of Dean's content coming this way. I am a huge fan. Next up, I am going to be tackling Libra Sonatine, that infamous, infamous piece. Anyway, let's crack on with Volsinsky. Okay, so we're up here at, you'll have had to have done a 2 to 11 slide, lasering ahead of your hand. We've got third finger at 11th fret on string 4, fret 9, fret 10. The fourth finger is just going to push up to the E. Open. Now, I would suggest you do a rest stroke because that A has to go across two bars, and then I suggest if a rest stroke here again is something that Dean has said in his master classes. Then going to float down to a C sharp and a B, fret 6 and fret 9. And third finger on an A at fret 7 with an open E and staccato. All right, bar 121. 7th fret. 3rd and 2nd, 7 and 6 on strings 4 and 3 respectively. Fourth finger is going to pull off to 5th fret, so a B to A lower. And then you are going to jump into 7th fret with a bar, but 2nd finger on the C natural at 8, 3rd finger on the E at fret 9, and your 4th finger on a G sharp. Lift your fourth finger up, just expose the F sharp underneath it, and then it is a lovely low E, D sharp to B, G, D, B, 4, 3, 2, open, and then you're going to bounce down to the third fret bar, and we'll pick it up from there in a second. So, all together, I'm going to go from the slide. Welcome back. We are at 124, bar 124. Second finger on 4th fret, 4th finger on 5th fret, C sharp and A. 3rd fret bar, 3rd finger in the middle on a B. Now, I would suggest with Dean's fingering is this. But I would suggest it's easier just to go straight into a bar because then that entire bar is going to shift up to fret 9, F sharp minor. This is a standard chord shape. Most of you should know this, hopefully. Minor 7. So, 3rd finger, 2nd finger, 3rd finger is just going to go down, C sharp to C natural, and then we're going to float down with another bar, 1st fret, so that we've got F natural, D sharp, A, D sharp, and then we're back into E again, and the end, it is F sharp, G sharp, open B, and then the same shape, just shifted up a string, C sharp, D sharp, open G. And then we really are back into the top with a repeat of this section. So the same as bar 97. Let's just take a look at that again quickly. So I'm here, bar 3rd fret, 2 and 4. Bar 4. 9, bar at 1. I'm I'm just sliding my first finger up. And then in. Slow motion from the bar before. For staying until the end. This has been brought to you by classicalguitarrocks.com, the home of six-string inspiration and the whole idea behind this channel. Head over there if you want to check out all the info, gossip, and extras that you need to get DNs up. There is already a full complement of lessons on Tango and Sky, that fantastic little piece that is the sister piece to this, along with Brower, Villalobos, and loads more. Grab some six-string inspiration today from classicalguitarrocks.com.